Now, I don't know if you have had the same issue, but every time I would open Pages or Keynote document and try to save it, or not even try to save it, it would just automatically try to save it, I would get an error message saying, there is not enough space to save this document to iCloud. Purchase additional storage or remove some documents from iCloud. And I'm like, I'm not trying to save it to iCloud. I just want to save it desktop or some other folder on my laptop. I don't need to save this to iCloud, but it would automatically try to save it like it was by default set up to save to iCloud. So it was very frustrating because even if I try to change the location where it's being saved, for some reason, I would still keep getting that message that it's trying to save it to iCloud and I don't have enough space. Because the way it was set up in the system, by default, it's trying to save to iCloud, and you have to work around and work very hard to try to change that. So I'm going to show you in this video how to manage the way your Pages and Keynote documents are being saved. To see all the current documents in your iCloud, click on Finder, and on the left under iCloud, you will see everything that's currently saved to iCloud. You can manage everything here just like any other folder. If I single click on Keynote or Pages, I can see the file there. If I double click on a folder, I go in the folder and I can select all the files here and move them to trash and then empty trash. However, this is only deleting everything that's currently there, not the future documents that will be saved there by default. To prevent future Keynotes and Pages document being saved to iCloud, first you have to click on System Settings, click on New ID, iCloud, and then under Manage, you will see what is taking most of the space in iCloud. And obviously pictures, photos taking most space for me, and Pages and Keynote just taking few megabytes, so it's not making that much of a difference. Click Done. Then under iCloud Drive, I have it on currently turned off, meaning documents are being saved to iCloud. I can turn it off so none of them are being saved there, or I can click on Options below, and here you have a check mark by each of the applications that it's saving documents by default to iCloud. Now, if I go down to Keynote and Pages, if I uncheck the Pages, then you can see in my Finders folder on the left, currently Pages and Keynotes are there. But once I uncheck the Pages, Pages disappears. And once I uncheck Keynote, the same thing happens. Keynote folder in my iCloud Drive disappears. So now by default, Keynote and Pages documents should not be saved there any longer. Now let's double check that that is true. Let's open a new Pages and Keynote document. So when I open a Pages document under Untitled, the title of the document, it does specify that it's being currently saved to desktop, no longer is being saved to iCloud. However, sometimes you may still see it as the default being saved to iCloud. So let's check the Keynote document. So when you open a new Keynote document, under Untitled, I can still see that it's trying to save to iCloud. So I can just change the location for this and future files, and then you can always adjust as needed. But at least I'm not getting the warning, iCloud is full, it's out of space, please purchase more additional space, etc. Now let's look at our Finder iCloud folder and see if Pages and Keynote folder is there. No longer is the case. You can always go back to System Settings, your ID, and then iCloud, and under iCloud Drive Options, and change your settings and bring back the Keynote and Pages to be saved to iCloud. And now you can see in the Finders, they showed up. So hopefully this helped you solve your issue. You no longer have the same annoying message that you are running out of space and you can't save your documents. So thanks so much for watching.